Hello everyone, welcome to Oracle Fusion HCM training by UnoGeeks. In this video, we'll see how to build a data model for a BIP report. BIP report, or in other words, a Business Intelligence Publisher report, is one of the main reporting options, and it can also be used as an outbound integration in Oracle Fusion HCM. So what is a report all about? You have information lying in a database tables. You need to pull that out and print that in a layout expected by the client. So that is all about a report, right? So for a BIP report also, you have to do the same thing. So you have to build a data model using SQL queries, and these SQL queries will hit the database tables, get the information required for the report, and later on, over the next few videos, we will see how to build an RTF layout and how to convert the XML output generated by this data model to PDF or any other formats. Okay. So in this video, we'll see how to build a data model using SQL queries, which will pull the data required for the report from a database tables and generates an XML file. So let's get started. So the use case is to build an employee assignment report as a BIP report. And this report needs to display employee personnel as well as assignment details. And this report is going to take a person number as an input. And the report needs to print the personnel details of that person, that the person number that you're passing in as input, and their assignment details. That's a use case. So we're going to build this as a master detail report or a parent-child report, wherein you print employee details in the master query, and you print the assignment details in a detail section or a child section. And what fields do we want to print from? Print in the employee header section. We want to pull the first name, last name, person number, and we'll also include the start date. And apart from these columns, which come straight from the database tables, we will also have an aggregate column to just display the number of assignments that the employee has worked on so far. So this will not be available in the database, but we're going to add this column as an aggregate column. Okay, we'll try to count the number of assignments that the employee has worked on, and we will display it on the parent query. So this is just to show you how you can use aggregate queries in a BIP data model. And in the line section, yes, we'll print the assignment information, and we'll pull few columns from the assignments, like the assignment name, number, start date, end date, and the action code. Okay, so let's get started. So first, let me show you, before we go ahead and build the report, let me show you where this information is available in the Fusion HCM application. So I've logged into the Fusion HCM application here. If you go into My Client Groups, and if you go to Person Management, search for a specific person. You can probably search for Casey Brown. Just search with Casey. Okay, pick up a specific employee. And if you click on the person details, you get to see all the details of the employee, all the personal details. If you click on person information, so you see the last name, first name, and you try to get these details, and you have the person number as well. So we'll get all these employee personal details. And similarly, if you go to assignments. Okay, so we're not able to see the assignments. Probably this user does not have the privileges to see the assignments, maybe. But let me just search for HCM user itself. Curtis PD. Okay, so if you scroll down, you see that this employee has a personal details, which I've just shown you. And to see that information again, you can click on the task ribbon, click on person, that will show the personal details. And the moment you open up a person record, you will be able to see the assignment that the person is working on. So he's working on as a human resource specialist. And this is his current assignment start date. And he's working on an assignment called E101 for US1 business unit. And so this is just the current assignment that he's working on. And in the past, he would have worked on a few more assignments, right? To see that history, you can click on view history here. That will show a list of assignments that employee has worked on in the past. So the expectation is that we need to build a report which will take in the person number as an input, print the employee personal details in the header section, and in the line section, it needs to print not just the current assignment, but all the assignments that you're seeing in this table, along with the relevant fields, such as a start date, what action created that assignment, etc. Okay, so let's get started. Click on done, and we'll have 101 employee number for our reference. Okay, and to build the report from the home page, you have to go to, so let's go back to the home page. Go to tools, reports analytics. You need not do anything in this intermediate screen. Just click on browse catalog, and that will take you into a catalog screen, which will connect you to the BI server. And this is where you typically build a BIP and OTBI reports. Okay, so you'll see two folders, my folders and shared folders. My folders, it's like your work area. If you place something in here, only you will be able to view it. Go to shared folders. In shared folders, again, there is a folder called custom folder. You should ideally create your report under custom folder, because a folder is upgrade proof, meaning if Oracle upgrades this instance or applies some patch, it ensures that it doesn't touch this folder. So you can be rest assured that your report will stay or will not be overwritten when instance undergoes a maintenance. So you can create a folder, click on the plus icon, create a folder. And you can give it a name. You can probably call it, you know, Geeks, expand. And under published reporting, so the options for a BIP report will be available under published reporting. You have a different type of reporting available called OTBI reporting, which we'll see in a future videos. And this analysis and interactive reporting, so these options belong to OTBI report. These options belong to a BIP report. So we need to first create a data model. This will hit the database tables, get the output in XML format. But I'll show you how that XML looks like. It will be very difficult to consume. So to convert that into a more readable format, we will auto-generate a report layout in the next video. So first, let's start off with the data model. A blank data model is created, and you need to add the data sets first, meaning you have to plug in your SQL queries. Click on the plus icon. You can use any of these options as a data source. Even though you're seeing many options here, 9 out of 10 cases, you will be using only SQL query as a data source. But please remember that in case you want to use a web service as a data source, you can do that as well. So in case you have probably built an integration in OIC and or any other integration tool, if you have got a web service which you want to use as a data source, you can do so with this option. Okay, so this will come handy in some scenarios, but most of the cases it will be SQL query. So click on SQL query, give it a name. You can probably call it as a person details. I'll just call it person. Yeah, you need to select the data source. This is important. So if you don't change this from default to HCM, so what options are available? First of all, if you click on the dropdown, you see application DB and you see three options. Depending on for which application you're building the report, you have to select the appropriate data source. Since I'm building this report for HCM module, I'll select HCM. If it is financials or SCM, you select this. CRM, you pick this. Select HCM, and you have to paste in the query here. So this is, so you know what fields you need to pull for an employee personal details, right? So you need to pull the first name, last name, person number, start date, and assignment count. So you have to come up with a query which will pull these details from the base tables. So the employee information will be stored in a table called ParallPeopleF, and the names information of an employee will be stored in a table called PerPersonNamesIF. So we need to link these two tables with the help of a person ID join condition. And in the names table, you will have multiple rows for different languages. So you can probably put in a filter which says name type equal to US. And for now, let's just hard code a person number. So we're hard coding 101 here, which is a Curtis Fitty employee number. So we're just taking a sample employee number. And this is what you normally do when you start building your report. And if you look at the columns, I'm pulling the first name, last name from the names table, person number from the person, from the people table, and the start date and the person ID again from the ParallPeopleF table, which is the employee main table, main base table. Okay, so let me copy this query, paste it in there. So coming up with this query, it'll be your job. And in case you're a fresher who wants to start your career with Oracle Fusion HCM as a technical consultant, you might find it a little bit difficult because from the user interface, from the screen where I've shown you the employee and other details, you will not be able to find out what table stores that information. If you have probably worked in EBS, you know that if you are looking at a particular form, you can figure out what table stores that information in the backend. But no such provision exists in ERP Cloud. There's no straightforward way. Okay, so you have to search for the table names in Google or a Metalink notes, and then come up with a query like this. Okay, after you build the query, add in the query, so that will add a data set. And if you want to execute the query, go to the data tab, click on view. By default, it will display only the first five rows. And the information will be displayed in a hierarchical view or a tree view. Most of us will not be comfortable with this. Change it to table view. So we have employee details pulled from the database tables. And let's go ahead and add in another data set, new SQL query. And let me call this as assignment. Select HCM again and paste in the lines query. In the lines query, I'm fetching the assignment information from Parallel Assignments table, and I'm fetching the required details like the action code, assignment name, number, start and end date, and I'm also formatting the dates to print it in a specific format. And I'm printing only the primary assignments. And I'm ordering the assignments by start date so that I'll see the latest assignment at the top. Okay. Add in the query, and if you notice in both the header and the lines query, I'm fetching in a person ID, which will be a unique ID for every person. And the reason I'm pulling this is I don't need to print this in a report, but still I need to pull it so that I can use this person ID column to join the header query and the lines query. Okay, so let's click OK. You see that we have two queries now, and this is a header query, or this is a person query, and this is an assignment query. And at the moment, these two queries do not have a link. Meaning if I execute this data model, both data sets execute on their own. So you see that the first query is resulting in a single record because we have hard-coded person number in there. But if you look at the second query is pulling the details of printing a few assignments. And it has printed five because by default, only the five rows gets printed. But if you look at the person ID, this has got nothing to do with the person ID of Curtis Fitty. Or in other words, these are not the assignments that Curtis Fitty has worked on. So how to fix this? To fix this, I need to link this query with the first query, or I need to link assignment query with the person query. And to do that, you need to have a common column in both the groups. And what common column do I have? A person ID. And how do I link it? Click on person ID from the employee table, person group, and drop it on the assignment table. and that too on a person ID column. And you see that the join is added now. And if you go ahead and run the data model now, view, click on table view, and you will be able to see the information now. And what do you see? You see the employee details, and you see the assignment details as well. And this is what we need for our report, right? So if you go back to the report use case, we need to print employee details, and we need to print the assignment information in the line section. And in the header section, we also want to add assignment count, which is not available in a database column, but we want to count the records that are fetched by this query and add it here. So to do that, what I can do is I can drag assignment number column. Okay, drag the assignment number column, and I will drop it on the box which says drop here for aggregate function. I'll drop it there. I'll edit the field properties, and I will say CS. I'll call it as assignment count. Okay, add it in, and you can select the aggregate function that you want to apply. If you want to probably sum up the lines amount and display it as a transaction total, you can do that. You can pick up a summary option, but here I want to display the count of assignments on the employee record. So I'll go with the count option and click OK. Save the data model. Let's save it to the same folder that we have created just now. Go to shared folders. And we created a folder called UnoGeeks under custom folder. So let's go to custom folder. Let's call it as UnoGeeks employee assignment data model. Okay, save the data model. And there are a couple of things that we need to change in the data model. In the main query, we have hard-coded the person number, meaning whenever you run this report, only the details of 101 employee gets printed. But that is not what you probably want, right? As per the report specification, we need to accept person number from the user and print that person details, that person employee personnel as well as assignment details. But if I go to data tab, it doesn't matter how many times I print it, it prints only the Curtis VT details and his assignment details. So to fix this, what I'll do is I need to parameterize the person number. So instead of hard coding the person number here, I need to parameterize it, or I need to receive it as a parameter. So to do that, I can add in a bind variable. Bind variable starts with colon, and you can say p underscore to indicate that it's a parameter. It's not required that you need to start your parameter with p underscore, but it'll be good if you follow a proper naming convention, because that's what you will be doing in real time as well. So you can say p underscore a person number, click OK. Data model asks you whether you want to create the bind variable as a parameter. Click on this. You see that there are no parameters at the moment, but the moment I click OK, you will see a parameter getting added there. You can assign a default value. You can probably say 101. And you can assign a display label. You can call it as person number. Save the data model. And you can go back to the data tab. You see that there is a person number parameter now, and the default value is 101. Try to print the details, and you see the details getting printed now. And if you change this, maybe change it to a random employee number or a different employee number. And if that person exists, we would have probably received the details of that person along with the assignment details. Okay, so 2259 is not a valid employee, because of which the report output is blank. So here, if I want to print a different person number, I should be playing a guessing game, right? If the parameter is a text field. Instead, let's add a list of values. Okay, let's add a query and try to create a list of values for a person number. And let's attach that list of values to this person number parameter so that we get to see a dropdown and we can pick up a different employee and run the report. To do that, to give users a list of values, I have to create a list of value first, go to list of values, add in a new list of value, and you can say person number LOB, SQL query, data source is going to be HCM, and you can paste in the query. And in the PPTF LOB query, I've captured the LOB query as well. So I'm just pulling a person numbers from ParolPeopleF, and I'm pulling only the employees who are effective as on today. So I'm checking where sys date between effective start date and end date, which means if there are 100 employees and if only 90 of them are effective as on today, pull only those 90 employees. Don't pull the 100. Don't pull the other 10 employees which are not active. Okay, so I'm excluding the inactive employees with this where clause. And if you look at the main queries, I have that condition on in my header query as well. And you will typically have these effective date check conditions in all the HCM VIP reports that you build. That's quite important. And let's add in the query. And after the query, after the LOV is created, go to the person number. To attach LOV to the parameter, you have to change the parameter type to menu. So you're seeing it as a text box because the type was text. So change it to menu. And the moment you change it to menu, you see a different options here. LOV is populated. And since there is only one that got selected by default, save the data model. And let's go out of the data model and come back in again. Let's save the report or save the data model. Leave it and come back to it again. Edit the data model again. So you see two queries in there and you have a parameter as well with a list of values. Go to data tab. And you see a dropdown now. And if you click on the dropdown, you see all the list of valid employees in the instance. You could probably sort them as well. You could have probably said order by person number. So let's pick up a different employee and let's try to print the details because we don't have any details for that specific employee. Okay, let's pick up a different employee number. Let's try to print the details. Or rather, what we could do is we can go back to the person management screen, pick up another employee who has a valid assignment, and we can print that employee here. Okay, so to look at to pick up another person number, go to My Client Groups, go to Person Management, and you can probably search for another employee called Mitch Blum. I know that this person has an assignment. Pick him up. And you see the employee number 618. Let's try to print this employee. Search 618. Pick him up and view the details. And as you can see, the details of the employee as well as the assignments are printed. So if you increase the number of rows, that will give us a clarity whether there are any more assignments apart from, if you have any assignment, if you have assignments more than 5, they get displayed if you change this default rows from 5 to maybe 10 or 20 or 50. Okay. So, we have achieved what we have what we wanted to at the start of the video. So we were able to create a data model using SQL queries for a HCM VIP report, and that is employee assignment report. But unfortunately, if you try to export this output, so yes, we have built this data model, but if I try to export this output, it gets exported in XML format. As you can see, the output is generated in an XML format. Let me just format this to explain, to show you how the XML format looks like. So XML format looks like this. It has a group tags and it has a start tag and end tag for each attribute. Like for first name, this is a star tag and this is an end tag. How do you know that it's an end tag? You have this slash before the start of end tag. And between the start and end tags, you have the actual values. So imagine this. I run this report. I'm going to run this report as an ESS job. We'll see how to register a BIP report as an ESS job in the later videos. But imagine user running this report and getting this XML as an output. It is very difficult to consume, right? And it doesn't make sense also to print this XML output directly to the end user who will not be able to make anything out of this. So it will be our responsibility to convert this XML to a more readable format such as a CSV or a PDF. And to do that, you have to create an RTF layout. RTF stands for rich text format. So you have to create an RTF layout to convert this XML output into a more readable format such as CSV or PDF. And in the next video, we'll see how to auto-generate that RTF layout. And the good news is, in EBS, you had to create an RTF layout from scratch, but you don't have to do it in ERP Cloud. In ERP Cloud, once you have created your data model, based on the data model, you can auto-generate the RTF layout. So in the next video, we'll see how to auto-generate that RTF layout. Okay. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. In case you are interested in Oracle Fusion HCM training offered by UnoGeeks, please call us on this number, 73960-3355, or you can send us an email on info@unogeeks.com. If you want to check out the course content of Fusion HCM, please visit our website. Thank you.